So your app's now in the state that the save profile method knows that when it's called, it should be passed data that conforms to the fields defined in the profile form class, which in practical terms means that the input data can include display name and t-shirt size. If it includes anything else, those fields will be ignored. However, our app wants to use the email, so we'll need to get the email, and we'll do that by getting the email of the logged in user. This of course means that the user must be logged in. So next we need to update save profile to take a user input argument and to throw an exception if the user isn't logged in. In the save profile method, you'll be adding a user argument as the first argument. This means that when the save profile method's called, the user will be passed to it automatically. If the user isn't logged in, then the user argument's going to be null. It's really easy to get the user. All you have to do is to add this argument to your endpoints method. So even though the user gets passed in, there's no automatic check that the user's logged in, so we need to do that check ourselves. So you can add the code to check if the user is null, and if it is, to throw an unauthorized exception. We also need to update our code to use the email and the user ID. We can get the email and the user ID by calling methods on the user. The user ID uniquely identifies the user, and the email, of course, is their email, which is going to be very handy when the app wants to send emails to them. The methods for getting the user ID and the email are fairly intuitive. Get email, get user ID. Wouldn't be too hard to guess those. We already have the code for getting the display name out of the profile form, but what if the user doesn't provide a display name? We can write code to set a default display name based on their email. The Conference API class already provides a function called extract default display name from email, which basically gets your name from your email but leaves off the at domain part. So for example, if your email is lemoncake@example.com, then the display name simply becomes lemoncake. And so it's pretty easy to just add the code to check if the display name is null, and if it is, to call this function. We already wrote the function for you. Obviously, need to save all your changes, then redeploy and see what happens. Now let's see what happens when we try out our app in the APIs Explorer. Just to be sure you're not logged in, go to the APIs Explorer in an incognito window in Chrome. Okay, let's see. Save profile and execute. Oh no, look, this method requires you to be authenticated. You may need to activate the toggle above to authorize your request using OAuth2. So the APIs Explorer knows that we're not logged in and that it requires a user, so we have to activate it. The only thing our app's doing right now with user information is getting their email, so it's asking the user to give permission for the app to get their email. Now let's resubmit. Maybe I'll add some properties. T-shirt size small. Then we execute. Now you see that the request went through. The request, the display name is Nikki and the t-shirt size is S, which is what I input. And you'll see the response includes the display name, the main email, the t-shirt size, and the user ID. One thing to notice about running your app on localhost is that no matter what your real email is, your email is going to be interpreted as example@example.com. And if your API doesn't throw an exception if the user's not logged in, then the user's going to be set to test@example.com. And you can, if you like, run this again without providing the display name. Let's execute it. And this time you see in the response that the display name is inferred from the email.